let's see. Top chat viewing options. Let's do a live chat. Pin chat. You can now pin a message to the top of chat for viewers to read. I know there are some people on here. I am literally just looking at and to see like what it is. All right, boom. Hello, hello there. Especially those who are joining in from TikTok. See, cross-platform migration is possible. You can get two or three. We are having... I'll be using this again soon anyway. It is... Okay. I was hanging out. It is so very hot in here because we've already started like warming up things, so I'm gonna take this sweater off. It was a nice sweater, but damn, is that a warm sweater. How are things going? How is everybody? Why can't I see the chat? There we go. Hello, from Hong Kong. Hello, Kenneth. Hello, oh, there's a lot of people in the chat. Hi, good morning, good morning, good morning. Hello, North Carolina, good morning. Luxembourg, good morning. Luxembourg, what's something I've heard somebody say about Luxembourg? The land of like 100 banks and one traffic light. I'm not sure if that's true anymore, but at one point in time. Hong Kong, hello. Ohio, as in the state, not as in Japanese for good morning. Winnipeg, Canada, hello. Rochester, New York, Dubai, Romania, Philippines, South Africa, Wisconsin, India, Virginia Beach, Thailand, Philly, Cali. Hello, everybody. All right. So today we have decided, and by we, I mean me and the voices in my head, have decided to make a healthier breakfast, like a brunchy, breakfasty thing. And by that, I mean like, we're going to do pancakes. We are going to do pancakes. And for pancakes, like, we're working with a mix because I don't really have time to like gather all the components that I need. So let's go and grab it. It's a Costco brand, but then I can still use a pre-made pancake mix and show you guys how to like get the most out of it. If indeed I do still have any more. I'm sure I do, I know I do. It's probably above the Inglewood, Florida, hi. I spent so much time getting ready for this thing only to like not be ready at all. Okay, there it is. I built this kitchen for like tall people and then I kind of like was very overzealous about it. Good morning from California. Good morning. So, I really like this stuff. This is pretty much like pancakes with protein powder in them. You can make your own. It's pretty easy. All you really have to do is take any pancake mix that you want, and then you add in to like a single serving, you add in a scoop of like vanilla protein powder. That's all this stuff is, just regular pancake mix with protein powder in it. This was on sale. This one is on sale and so that's why I bought it. And it's pretty good, it's not bad. It does require the use of an egg to get them fluffy. So I definitely would recommend you always put egg in it. There are measurements on the box, but I'll just show you how to do it so that you don't have to measure, because who has time? Who has time? Ouch. Mochi will eventually be with us. I'm sure she'll join us in here. When she hears me cooking, my dog will join us. Big-ish bowl. Okay. So we're going to do pancakes, and then we're going to do a sugar-free blueberry compote, because I've got blueberries here that are going bad. There's a thing of sugar plums up there. I don't even know how to use them. I just bought them because it said a box of sugar plums and I was fascinated. But let's do... For sugar-free blueberry compote, it's very easy. You take a pan, you add in your blueberries, and you just let this go. You just continue to let this go. So that's like, that was like a 3/4 cup of blueberries. That is 1 1/4 cup. That is 2 cups. I'm doing the guesstimation of measurements for your benefit, because I personally don't care how much is in anything. So there we go. We got about 2 1/2 cups of blueberries. Fresh blueberries in there. Now, there are various ways that you can go about doing this. You could use something like this, which is like a Monkfruit erythritol typed. I would have dumped them all in there too, but my dog really likes them, so I use them as dog treats as well. So I just save, I'm literally saving some for like Mochi. So as this cooks off, you can see like already like the juice of the blueberries is starting to cook out of it. And you can just, and remember, this is probably, this stuff is probably, I would say, 3/4 as sweet as regular sugar is. So you usually have to use more. That being said, it is not, it is, this stuff is passed through your body the same way that fiber is. It's not digested and you're not, it's not added to anything. So let's see. We've got, I'm putting in 1/2 cup. Yeah, I'm putting in 1/2 cup. Now, one of the things with this is that once it cools, it will immediately solidify and crystallize. So it has to stay warm. But you do want warm compote on your blueberries anyway. You can also cut it with a little bit of, what's it called? They make a maple syrup version of this, and you can cut it with that, and that will help keep it liquid. But you just kind of just let this go. And once the water and the juice is extracted from the blueberries, it will mix in with this stuff, and then you'll have pretty much a sugar-free jam, except for the sugar that's naturally in the blueberries themselves, that you can add on to the pancakes that we're making. I'm going to spice mine up just a touch with some Ras Al Hanout. This is a Moroccan spice or a North African spice blend. Beautifully gingery, cardamom-y, with a little bit of turmeric in it as well, along with some like other stuff. I see some star anise. They use star anise in there. Yeah. And it's got really a nice, really bright aroma. So we're just gonna let that cook in there. And since it's gonna get super, super hot, because sugar and juices get quite hot as it cooks down, it will still also activate the spices in the Ras Al Hanout. Whatever spices you've got around the house, put in some garam masala, put in some 5-spice, anything that would go with a nice sweet profile. But you can see, like, you know, it's starting, it's already happening. Using a nonstick pan will make your life extremely easy. And since we're dealing with mostly liquids in here, it doesn't actually get to a temperature that is dangerous to use nonstick with. I like to use my nonstick pans for a very specific purposes only. And that is for to cook eggs, to melt cheese, and to make more delicate sauces. I know it falls way below the temperature threshold of what makes nonstick dangerous, but hey, you've got a lot of other pans that you can use for all the other things that you need pans for that don't have essentially a toxic material that are connected to them. But, you know, for the convenience of it, I try to like keep it a little bit sensible and realistic. And let's face it, I have willingly put a lot of much worse things in my body for free. So my clock agrees. All right, so while this is going, let's make a little bit of, I've got some chocolate peanut butter powder over here. I love to add this to my smoothies, but you can also use it to make a paste or make peanut butter. So we can do like a Ras El Hanout blueberry compote on pancakes. But then you can also use this stuff to make peanut butter, chocolate peanut butter and banana pancakes, which we will do using nothing but peanut butter powder with chocolate in it and some chocolate protein powder. When I said healthy-ish, I mean like it's still gonna taste good, but it's gonna be beneficial to you and, I don't know, your gains, I guess, if that is like what you're looking for. The point is, not to, in a way, we're gonna do one scoop. We're just gonna do one scoop of their own, like it's the protein powder scoop in there. One scoop of chocolate protein powder. And one serving, which is 2 tablespoons of peanut butter powder with chocolate in it. And because we're dealing with a lot of like artificial sweeteners and stuff, we're going to add a pinch of salt to it, because salt will make all of those like fake-ish sweetness flavors. It balances it all out and it makes things just taste a little better. And who doesn't like salted peanut butter chocolate? It just adds like a depth and a nuance to it. And this is really easy. You just have to rehydrate it. This is almost like sci-fi cooking where you just add water and suddenly you have food. Or camp cooking, I should say. Most protein powders these days have like something in them that like really sucks in moisture and water. And it kind of like naturally turns itself into water. So you saw like how little water I put in there. But because protein powders are supposed to dissolve really easily, because so they can like maximize their use in shaker bottles and stuff like that, I might have put in like a tablespoon of water in there and suddenly you have this like chocolate sauce. That's nice. Mm-hmm. That's gonna be really nice with bananas. Here's the blueberries. Now we're going to add, the Ras El Hanout smells really good in this. To be quite honest, I've never put Ras El Hanout in a blueberry compote before, but it sounds like good things I should have been doing all this time. We're going to let this reduce. If it needs it, we'll give it a hit of acid, like a lime juice or a lemon juice. But we will cross that bridge when we get to it. Walnuts for the pancake batter, naturally. So again, am I going to measure? No. So we're just gonna go by what looks good. I'm only one person today, so I won't be making that much. And even then, I'm going to probably like save these for leftovers for later. Maybe use the pancakes to like make a little sweet treat after it's leg day today. So give myself a little bit more. I say this is like 1.5 cups. Handful of walnuts, crush it so that they can more easily incorporate in as bits. You can buy pre-made walnut bits as well, naturally. Walnuts are great because they've got a lot of B vitamins and they just go very well with all sorts of like sweet applications. But B vitamins provide you with plenty of natural energy. And apparently walnuts are really good brain food. Like people, I've seen it on the internet where it's like, oh, it's shaped like a brain and it also happens to be really good for brain development. I don't know if that's a lie or not, but you can confirm it in the chat, which I cannot see. It's really annoying that I have to like move my phone around so I can see the chat. It's very different from TikTok because I guess YouTube doesn't encourage as much interaction with the chat as much as TikTok does. So I guess I just feel like I constantly be having to do shit and we can't really chill. Eggs. Got some eggs. I think one is enough. So pancake mix, waffle mix, pancake mix, all of this stuff. It doesn't really require eggs, but putting eggs in here does boost the nutritional value of the mix itself, but also it's a very good binder. And so it adds a lot of structure to the pancakes. So having eggs or whisking eggs in gives you fluffier pancakes. So I always put an egg in when I make pancakes. I don't know if you're a vegan, you could use aquafaba maybe. That should probably work. Like the chickpea water. Just a little bit of water at a time. Also very important is not to overmix your batter. If you mix your batter too much, you do something with the gluten in there and it makes for flat pancakes. So you do want like there to be not a lot of gluten development as you move it around. And by not move it around, it's like some lumps are okay, is pretty much what I mean. And by lumps, I mean like lump out of the batter, not lumps as in the walnuts. So that'll be good. I like my pancakes to have a little bit more structure to them, so I don't like them to be, I can mix this a little more. Bam. We'll let that sit for a little bit. Let it come up to room temperature. Let's see how we're doing with this blueberries. Good, 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 good. Very nice. Very, very beautiful color. I don't know if it just looks black to you, but it's like got this really deep, rich purple. Mmm. Very nice. Complex from the spices. It does need just the slightest hit of acid. Lemon juice or lime juice? Lemon juice. Oh, hold up. I've got lemon juice, but I also have preserved lemon paste from this company as well. I could try that. Where is that? That's harissa. This is preserved lemon paste. New York Shuk. Preserved lemons are great, but whoo, this smells lovely. What is the nutritional value of this stuff? What's in here? Lemons, lemon juice, sea salts, nutrition facts. Yeah. Nominal amount of anything that I care about. So let's give it a taste and let's see if this is something we can use in our compote. And if you don't have preserved lemon paste, obviously lemon juice would work. I was gonna use that. Yeah, yes, yes, yes. That tastes grown up. It's got some bitterness to it. No small amount of salt. Nice little tartness. Feels like got some, it feels like it's almost tannic in a way. The way that it dries out your mouth like a good wine. A little more. That is really good. We are reducing nicely as well. Hell yeah. That's it. That's the money right there. I'm just gonna not waste the last few drops from the spoon. So, lemon juice or preserved lemons. And by now, our pancake should be, or at least ready. Hold on. Let me. Working with my, like, flexible foot tripod so that you can see this a little better. Now, if I were making bacon today, I would have had bacon in the oven probably like 15 minutes before I started the live, and the bacon would be ready by the time I finished all this. Bacon's a little boring to watch cook, because the proper way to cook bacon is always in the oven. On a rack or off the rack, depending on how crispy you like it. We'll just do them one at a time. I always put them in the middle of the griddle. Not thinking that if I put it off to the side, I could put so, I guess I could just put smaller ones off to the side, but like, that's fine. I never account for the spread. I'm not a brunch guy or even a breakfast cook. Small ones, big ones, they're all beautiful, just like you. All shapes, all sizes, everyone is perfect. Now, how do you know when pancakes are done? Basically, when the sides of the pancakes start to be a little bit dry, you'll notice like the sides start to get a little dry on their own. That means like the bottom of it is nice and like ready, and you're ready to flip. I didn't give myself a lot of room for a lot of error in my flip. I see that now. I didn't think this through. Basically, I didn't think this through, and I might mess this one up in particular, but that's fine because it's Saturday. It's Saturday for everyone. My background music was once used in a Hong Kong horror movie. Probably. I think it was also used in Crazy Rich Asians. It's a very famous song. Dita Von Teese does have a stove like this. She has it in British Racing Green. Middle of the griddle. Let's see. Are we almost there?
Yeah, we're about there.
Here we go. You want to see me fuck this up? I'm sorry. I'm used to being bleeped by my editors. So we'll just let this overgo, and like that way I can just work on these smaller boys first and maybe just move them so that they're not, God damn it, come on. Don't embarrass me. I am a professional. I do this for a living. There we go. This is shit. That's fine, it's fine. Can you tell I work with woks mostly? Damn it! There we go. All right, so now this guy right here. Just give each one a little happy little pat because they've all been like, they're all good little pancakes. Here we go, 1, 2, 3. Oh, yes! No touchy. Yeah, I meant to do that. You can see like how much water there was just in these berries alone. And obviously erythritol, when it's like, it has a very low melting point. So there's like, it's just becoming so, so rich. Are y'all sending me congrats for flipping pancakes? Small boys. Have I dug myself out of the snowstorm yet? No, I refuse to shovel. Fuck shovel, sorry. But fuck shoveling because it's gonna be 40 degrees today. We had a snowstorm, but it's almost all gone. Like, look, it's all melting away. So why am I gonna shovel? Why am I gonna salt? It's just gonna run off into the water, run off into the ocean, not ocean, the Detroit River. It's a weekend. Yeah, let it melt. Don't waste your rock salt. Don't waste I would shovel just for the workout, but I don't even want to do that because I'm going to go to the gym once the roads have all like cleared themselves out. And yeah, and it's also Saturday, so nobody's walking by my house. Not before the pavement clears itself out. And it's also going to be like 40 degrees tomorrow. And it's like 31 degrees tonight. So it's not going to ice over. I don't think it's going to ice over. If it does ice over, then I'll salt, but I'm not going to shovel. What is my workout motivation? Well, I worked for the longest time. I worked in kitchens, right? And I found a lot of value in being like a strong person in there. I didn't pat this as a good little pancake. I found that there was a lot of value in being just like brutishly strong in the kitchen. Like being able to lift a like 10-gallon stock pot. A 10-gallon stock pot from the burner right to the thing. So I've always been, you know, somebody who minded my fitness, but working in restaurants, I found myself more useful and more helpful to the people around me if I was just able to do stuff, like lift the heavy things without injuring myself. I do believe like pancakes are just larger and flapjacks are just smaller. So we've got, here we go. These are walnut protein pancakes. I already put them. I don't know if you can eat these, baby. I would give you one, but let's see what the ingredients are. Oh, can somebody look online real quick to see if dogs can eat walnuts? Are walnuts dangerous to dogs? I don't think so. What is in here? Whole grain flour, oat flour, wheat protein, whey protein, brown sugar, milk protein, buttermilk. Leavening. Yeah. These are all dog safe products in that protein mix. I mean, it's only one. I'm gonna give her one, but don't do it, Mochi. Is that your PR? No walnuts? Okay. Sorry. You can't have any, but you know what you can have? A Kraft single. We'll give you some cheese. Yeah?
Come here. American cheese is the best cheese for a burger because when you melt it, it doesn't split. What movie is that from? Speak. Oh, good girl. Speak again. Oh, good girl. Speak again. Oh, good girl. Sipri. Good girl. Bang. Oh, bang. Oh, she's hurt. She's hurt. Okay. Slowly, gently, gentle, gentle. Oh, good girl. I'm gonna have a piece too. I don't know.
Okay, so.
We have our Ras Al Hanout blueberry compote.
We have. Oh, did the internet cut out? I'm sorry. I didn't even know. Is it still working now? Are we back on? Is it it's okay? Okay, cool. So here we got the little pancakes. We'll do for the big one. For the big one, we'll do the blueberry. And then for the little ones, we'll do banana. Dogs can have banana though, right? Can they have banana? Banana is safe for dogs. Yeah, that's right. Okay. One banana. Good girl. No, that was it. You can't. No. You can't have any more. I'm sorry. That's. Your union contract only says a specific amount of banana every day. Who's that? Ooh, but she's sitting. I wish you could see more of the purple. Can I turn the light up? Is it more obvious? Well, it's kind of obvious when you got the light right there. It's actually like very, very deep purple. So there is a chocolate peanut butter, well, I should say protein pancakes, walnut protein pancakes with a chocolate peanut butter powder protein sauce and a no sugar added. And by that I mean only the blueberries are the real sources of digestible sugar in here, with Ras El Hanout blueberry compote. And that was pretty easy. There is like nothing in here that has, there's no like tons of added sugar in this. If anything, the natural sugar comes from the fruit itself, which is great. Sugar is not something that we should vilify, but it's also something that we should control. That was really hot and delicious, but that definitely burned my tongue a little bit. That's really good. That was really painful. So let's see, calorie wise, not that we should be counting calories, but let's see. 3 4-inch flapjacks. This is one. This would be like two. So this is like, the pancakes themselves are 190, plus 2 cups of blueberries, 2 cups of banana, 1 scoop of protein powder. That is the real major sources of calories in here. So yeah, this is a heavy breakfast, and it's like a weekend breakfast for sure. But it's not just about the calories, right? It is the quality of the calories themselves. So you have a good source of whole grain carbs, whole grain wheat, vitamins from the antioxidants from blueberries. Everybody knows banana is good for you. And protein from the sauce. And a little bit of fat from the peanuts in this, but you need peanuts to feel full. So I'm gonna go ahead and eat this now before it gets cold. My goodness, this is really nice. Let me like lower this tripod thing again. Bone apple teeth. Got my tea here. And like this is almost like cheating on a cheat day meal, because it is like, it's good for you. I mean, naturally, like if this were, I would probably be splitting all this between two people. But yeah, let me see if I can turn chat back on so I can like see chat all the time and actually like have a conversation with you guys while I eat. Oops, that's not what I tried to do. What kind of chocolate sauce is that? So the chocolate sauce is made out of 1 scoop of chocolate protein powder, a few teaspoons of water, and 1 serving of chocolate peanut butter powder, which is, some people, they're like, you see it there, they have it at Costco as a different brand. I use PB2. It's like 50 calories per serving, which is 2 tablespoons. And for the amount, I use it in my smoothies, I use it in chocolate sauce. For the amount of flavor that they provide a thing, it's very, very like valuable, I should say. Kodiak is a national park. Kodak is the camera company. Kodiak is the park. And Kodiak, I think they're known for like grizzly bears. Which is why I don't remember which Aladdin movie it was, but I remember when Genie said like, Like someone was, I think like there were two people and they were like kissing and the genie in Aladdin was like, oh, it's a Kodiak moment. And then this random bear just like comes in like roaring at his face for like no apparent reason. I didn't get that joke until I was like in my 20s, but it was always in my head as in like, this should be funny and I don't know why as a child. Oops. Are you... Do you have a favorite weekend breakfast second to pancakes? I like this, but with a little bit of bacon. What are I putting in the blueberries? The blueberries I melted down with some I'm just changing the angle to make it even funnier. There we go. It was the straight to VHS Aladdin. I'm so glad that somebody, got it. Looks good. And couldn't you tweak for variety, like strawberries instead of bananas and yogurt instead of peanuts? Maybe just thinking about all the different things my husband and I, oh yeah, for sure. I would actually replace the blueberries with the strawberries and like cook those down because those turn into a really, really like beautiful compote as well. She's my co-star. Just sitting watching me eat. You had breakfast already. And also you got some croissant this morning, so. I was hoping there would be a way to tell you to thank you. You taught me how to properly cook mushrooms, game changer. I'm so glad that you got something out of that. I hope. You know, and it's an easy thing, right? I hope it is something that you like enjoy for the rest of your life. But their breakfast didn't look like that. No, it sure didn't. Fried bananas in brown butter and brown sugar and hit it with a little bit of rum. That sounds kind of like crepe Suzette, and that sounds amazing. I would do that. I would eat that for sure. It would have to be like a holiday. Bananas Foster, that's right. That does sound like Bananas Foster. Last time I had Bananas Foster was before the pandemic when I took a trip to New Orleans. I don't remember what they put in it. But I passed out afterwards from a sugar crash. That was worth it. Mochi is a pit bull plus, a pit bull plus. I don't know what the plus is, but she's just very obviously, she's very like, look at this. Like she's just the sweetest thing. Sweetest thing barred by a lot of homeowners associations. So lucky, it's lucky you live in this house. She might have a little bit of lab in her. How long have I been a cook? Probably over 12 or 13 years. Chef for like 6. Asian American fusion with Spanish fondant. That sounds delicious. Your grandmother probably like could throw down.
right here.
You're such a creep.
You are.
Oh, damn it. I got chopper sauce on my jeans.
It's okay. This will wash out.
Microgreens. I used to work with microgreens a lot. I was obsessed with them when I was like a little young chef. My plates always looked like a grassy fucking meadow. Little microgreens. I loved working with edible flowers. Like, it just, it was very, I wanted everything, every dish that I ever made to look like a Miyazaki landscape, which, you know, was great for its time. Now I'm just kind of like, it's a little played out. I want more purpose in the garnish. I think we're progressing from like, garnishes used to like not be edible back in the day. They'd put like, you know, plastic grass on sushi, like why? And now we're doing like microgreens and flowers and stuff like that. Some of the microgreens taste delicious. Like sorrel. Sorrel is delicious. They taste like lemon. They're like little red, beautiful leaves that taste like lemons. Arugula flowers taste like pepper. Of course, you got your micro basil, lemongrass. You got chive. Oh, micro chives are still very, very nice, I think. But like most of them, like bull's blood, like with these like baby beets that are just like red, I don't care. Amaranth, I barely taste anything. So it's filler, but it's the most, oftentimes it's the most expensive part of the dish. I've got pancake stuck in my throat. Excuse me. And so like I'd shied away from microgreens right before I started making content and really focused on like things to make the dish stand on its own. Like kind of like, why does this need zhuzhing up? People should just know that this looks delicious. Like if it's like a curry on rice, I used to have put a lot of microgreens on it, flowers on it, because I didn't think it was like pretty. But now I look at it and I was like, that's beautiful on its own, because I know exactly what that tastes like, and it's gonna taste freaking amazing, and no amount of little tiny grass is going to make that taste better. I mean, sprouting legumes and like nuts and stuff, microchives are like, they're like almost little green hairs. And they actually still have the seeds still on them. They do taste very much like chives in a way that like, and can like get onto a dish that is it in a very like interesting way, but you can overuse them. But I still like those very much because they still taste very oniony. South Indian dishes, there is a chance that I've had some, but I just don't know the name for them off the top of my head, because I love Indian food. But otherwise, it's something that I want to explore more. Indian cuisine, besides the use of spices, is not something that I'm very well versed in, but it's something that I enjoy very much. Like, I love to go to an Indian restaurant and eat at an Indian buffet. Because there's just so many things you want to try. You don't know the names for any of them. But they just all look delicious. Controversial question. I love stinky tofu. I've got like a bunch of different kinds in my fridge. You have to know how to use it. It's really about like knowing what it's good for. So there are some stinky tofu, as example, that I blend in to use in my
barbecue sauce, for example, because it adds like an umami, like funky note to it. That's just like, it's like a good kind of stank. And then there are some other stinky, there are some others that are just like, this is just salty to me. I don't like it. Some of them are spicy as well. Some of these stinky tofus have been like marinated in sweet Chinese wine. Those are delicious. Those I could just like mash up into some rice and eat on its own. Yeah. Thank you, Wensho. I'd read your comment out, but I'm just like, I just took a huge bite. What? She's looking out the window. Barking at folks. You better not, please don't be a Karen. So, you know what I said? Like, the thing is with using monk fruit sweetener or erythritol,
oh shit, that was the mailman.
The one thing with it is making a compote out of monk fruit sweetener, on one hand it is sugar free and it acts like fiber, but on the other hand it has to be hot. Otherwise, it solidifies and becomes hard. So you have to eat it quickly or keep it warm. Otherwise, it turns... That being said, it now turned into icing. It has now turned into, like, this really tart, spiced, like, icing on my pancake. And I don't hate it. I'm still eating it. Because now it's, like, a treat. But that being said... If you wanted something saucy, it has to stay on the stove. And that's like the downfall of using erythritol and monk fruit sweetener. That being said, it also has, this has a lot of, what's it called? Potential in desserts. She was like, I guarded the house. Now pay me. Am I creating full time? I am creating full time now. So now it's kind of got the texture of like... What's the texture I would describe this as? Kind of like the Pop-Tart icing. Which, that could be a thing there. There could be a... That is a whole nother ball game. The Rivian's good. Got another recall. For like passenger seatbelt stuff. I'll get it done on Monday. First recall was fine. They came to the house and fixed it. I didn't even know that they like did. Drop some affiliate links for the stuff I use. I will do that every now and then. But like, that's a nice to have, but there are some things that you can just get cheaper, not on Amazon. So I don't want them to encourage, like for example, like this stuff. People buy a lot of this stuff after I talked about it. And they were asking for my affiliate link for it, but it was like literally, I don't know. First of all, on Amazon, This stuff is literally like 5-6 times more expensive than you'd find it at the store. So I found that to be unconscionable. So I was like, no, I don't want to make money off of somebody else, people getting ripped off. Plus, also the other thing is, a lot of Chinese grocery stores sell this, and I would rather people go and support their local Chinese grocery store and buy it from there and look it up and maybe get to know their Chinese grocery store a little bit. That being said, that kind of backfired a little bit because I noticed that there were more there were more non-Chinese people at the Chinese grocery store last week than there were Chinese people, which had been the first time in 15 years that I had ever, 15 years of going there, that I had ever seen that in my life. I don't know how and it made me feel some kind of way because I was just like, we as a people are not coughing loud enough in this building. they are getting too comfortable, you guys. Just a little, let's just do a little bit of that more. Like, just, you know, right over the produce. We'll switch it out when they leave. H Mart's would not have this. This is a very Chinese thing. How long do I plan on creating content as a job? For as long as it is lucrative. I'm paid a lot more now making content than I was as a cook. Mm-mm-mm. I'm full though. I did good damage to it though. John Selig was, I've always been this way. I just don't. 99 Ranch would 100% have it, and so would Grey Wall. And if you live by a 99 Ranch, I'm jealous because they Instacart. I have to drive to mine. Yeah, this is icing blueberries. This is nice. Mm. I was at Freya last year for Valentine's Day. Or our birthdays. It was for our birthdays. And it was good. It was really good. It was a nice experience, and I'm glad I had it in Detroit. What time is it? Oh shit, the gym's been open for an hour. I think we will be making... I think I will be making, what's it called? Pop-Tarts with this sugar-free icing. I like this idea. I designed this range hood. Thank you, I'm glad you liked it. I designed this kitchen. So. That's the difference between cooking for a living and cooking for the internet. At least it was for me. Well, thank you. Okay, well, it's time for me. You've had food this whole time? She just finally realized. She was like, hold up. You've had food this entire time, just sitting next to me. And now that I'm done with my breakfast, she's like, oh, okay, I guess I'll have mine now. Listen here. Sneaky lady. I know. Who's a sneaky girl? Who's a sneaky girl? She just popped her head around, like making sure I wasn't good. I miss being a chef at restaurants. The one thing I miss most about like working as a chef in restaurants was being like, I wasn't a mean person. I never screamed. I never threw anything and stuff like that. I was the type of person that would like, everything was fine until somebody messed up majorly. And then I would get quiet because I didn't want to be the person that like lashed out. And I also, our service stations were within feet of the table that we would serve. So when I was mad, I would be quiet. I'd be super focused on my thing. And you know, I would send out waves, vibrations, negative vibrations to the person who messed up so that they very quietly knew and would never do it again. But I will say that like, I do miss being feared and respected just a little bit because Lord knows that she does not. What do you think I did? You're still eating your food. My co-star here don't give a shit about you're not scared at all, are you? You are not. You don't fear me. Chocolate covered peanut now. Yes. She's a goober. All right. Now I am gonna head out. Well, the snow's all melted then. There's no snow on the roads. I hope everybody has electricity back from the storm. I hope everyone's safe and warm. And I hope you all have a lovely rest of your weekend. Actually, I might do, oh no, that's gonna be a video. That's gonna be a short. So yeah, I'll see you next time. This was very fun and I hope to see you again soon. And cook with me again next time. See ya.